What is going on, TTC? What is going on, Niner family?
Woo!
Sorry for the break, but unfortunately, you're getting a dark freaking video as shit because, well, blame nature. Anyway, Redskins week, and once again, I apologize to New Orleans fans. I didn't give you guys a hate week last week. Oh well, shit happens. It's the nature of the beast sometimes. But anyway, so the Redskins come into town, and you know, unfortunately, I think this is I think it's just the end of the year. Everybody's a little tired, but the Redskins come in. Niners are actually going to their house, but I say come in. And most of their fans have already freaking called this a season. You know, they've already given up on the season. They think RG3's just having a shitty year. And it's the truth. I mean, second quarter's been playing well, but unfortunately, this team's already down by so many freaking points that they can't come back. I mean, I don't get it. I don't get how, you know, he could play so bad in the first half. And, you know, he better have a damn good first half, because the 49ers defense will exploit if he makes mistakes. They will exploit him and abuse him. And the Redskins D has been so horrible this year. I mean, this should be an easy game. The Niners should get back to running the football and get everybody healthy. Either this week or next week's when Crabtree's coming back. And everything's going to be okay, Niners fans. I saw something ridiculous, like LaDainian Thomas has us losing two fucking games of the next, I think we got six left. Yeah. We got six or seven left. I'm sorry, guys. I'm freaking out of it. I'm tired of shit. But I think we got six or seven games left in the season. And he's got us losing two. And going freaking six losses this season. Going 10-6. Which is complete bullshit. I don't care how bad the Niners are playing. The Niners only lost to some damn good teams. Okay? They lost to Carolina by one fucking point. And they should have won the damn game. And if it wasn't for what I called an iffy call, a 50-50 call, the refs error on the side of judgment, which is, and shame on you, NFL, for wanting to fine Ahmed Brooks for that hit, because that's bullshit. That was complete fucking bullshit to call that fine. That's fucking stupid. You know it was a bang-bang play. You know it wasn't dirty. It wasn't a, I mean, just because he hit, because he, in your interpretations, hit him in the neck, it deserves a 15 freaking grand fine. Stupid. Bullshit. Anyway, defense, you know what? The Niners have lost two straight games for this the second time now. And I don't see this as a big deal, fans. I really don't. You know, I mean, the play call has been bad, but I mean, what do you expect when, I mean, there's only one wide receiver out there getting separation at the moment. Mario Manningham has, you know, hasn't gotten his legs back. You know, and the defense has been playing without Alden Smith being 100%. I mean, he missed a month, and he's out there playing again. And it's going to just be time before he starts sacking people. The defense has been carrying this team this year. And everybody's hoping and praying to God the 49ers don't make it to the playoffs. Because once we get to the playoffs, I think, you know, Harbaugh and Roman take the fucking leash off of Kaepernick and let him actually run around. Because right now, that's the only thing I'm seeing as a problem, is they're making Kaepernick think too much. There's a time when you could, you know, where thinking and being an intelligent quarterback and everything, and then there's just letting him play a little bit. And Harbaugh and Roman are so afraid of losing Kaepernick, they have just not let him play. They water it down. They don't, you know, they're making him throw first. And it's, you know, it's a neutered offense. It really is. It's the best way to put it is just it's neutered. When they're playing well is when, you know, Kaepernick is able to run around, make, you know, extend plays or get a couple of yards, get positive yardage. And, you know, the times when the offense has struggled is when teams stop the run and then make Kaepernick, you know, stay in the pocket, which is going to happen to a lot of second-year quarterbacks, or pretty much second-year quarterbacks. I mean, now is the time where he's, Kaepernick's actually a second-year quarterback, where he's played a full year, and he's now in his second year as a quarterback. And, you know, and you lose your number one wide receiver for most of the year, and the guy that you brought in to be a number two to make this offense more dynamic is having to play the number one spot. And yeah, it's gonna be some tough sledding sometimes, guys. And everyone jumping off the fucking bandwagon and shit, good. Fuck you. I didn't want you asses in here anyway. And, you know, good riddance. Go ride the Panthers nuts or something. I don't care. You know, whatever. Do whatever you want to do. Then Hall of Fame comes out. And if somehow, someway, Roger Craig, Charles Haley, or Eddie DeBartolo don't make it into the Hall of Fame this year, I don't know what to do. I really don't know. I mean, right now, you've got the NFL Network freaking sucking off Terrell Davis, who, don't get me wrong, for those 2 years when the Broncos were winning championships in the late 90s, Terrell Davis was a freaking stud running back. Was a freaking stud. But this is not the hall of two very good years and, you know, and a few other good ones. It's the Hall of fucking Fame. You know, don't get me wrong, I love Curtis Martin, but I don't think Curtis Martin deserves to be in the Hall of Fame. And everybody's gonna get on me, you know, he has like the third, you know, most rushing yards and everything and all this. Name me 1 year he was the leader in yards for a season. Name me one, please. Name me one where he led the league in rushing touchdowns or total touchdowns by a running back. Name me one thing that where he led the league, where he was the standard bearer. He was always second or third best running back in the league. This is the Hall of Fame, not the Hall of Very Good. Roger Craig was a very good running back on some very good offenses. I mean, he was the guy running the football for the 49ers when Montana and Bill Walsh had that thing cooking. And everybody thinks that the West Coast offense, they just threw the ball all over the damn place. They ran the ball a lot. And Roger Craig was the guy running that rock. And then Charles Haley, who, you know, for me, I have a little, it's hard for me because when I see Charles Haley, I see him as more of a cowboy than I do a 49er. But the dude led the league in sacks a couple of years. And this was, you know, during a time where you had guys like Lawrence Taylor and, oh God. You had some of the best defensive ends in ever. And those guys are in the Hall of Fame, but yet Charles Haley is not. And I'm sorry I'm running a blank on people on defensive ends during the early 90s, late 80s. It was a little bit before my time, so it's not Thurman Thomas, but there was another Thomas that played for the Bills that was a freaking disruptive guy. He's in the hall, but yet Charles Haley's not in the hall because he had some off-the-field issues. And the same thing with Eddie DeBartolo. How can you have guys like Ron Wilson and everything in the Hall of Fame as owners who didn't win or change the NFL like Eddie DeBartolo did, but yet because you had to kick him out of the league, you're going to just completely shun Eddie DeBartolo. An owner who won five freaking championships as his time as the owner of the 49ers. I mean, when Jed York took over the 49ers, the first damn call he made was to his uncle Eddie. Eddie DeBartolo, although being a complete maniac and a crook, is still deserving to be in the Hall of Fame as an owner. And, you know, while you're celebrating all these other owners and everything, why not give props to a guy who has the rings and the hardware to prove it and actually made the San Francisco 49ers into what, that, you know, helped do that. He paved the way. He was involved. He was just as passionate as anybody else, any other fan could be, about his 49ers. I read a book once called The Genius. It's about Bill Walsh, and there were stories about how DeBartolo had to be calmed down after bad losses because he just couldn't stand losing. And, you know, Bill Walsh, the one thing that he was always afraid of, he was always afraid of letting down Eddie DeBartolo because he knew DeBartolo would have no problem changing coaches if he had to. Now, of course, he didn't because it was Bill Walsh, but that just shows how committed he was to winning. But that's my Hall of Fame rant. I mean, really, it's going to be a Monday Night Football game. As long as the 49ers stop the run game and they stop Morris, then the Redskins have no shot in this game. Because their offense has been pretty anemic under Shanahan this season. And their defense has been really bad. So this should be a beatdown game on Monday Night Football for the 49ers. And then it's off to Atlanta. Anyways, gentlemen, they're signing out. Peace out. Go Niners.